Motamasi, bringing you the latest happenings in dancehall and reggae music. Welcome, it's Motamasi, and here are the stories making the cut for today. Anja Holness caught doing this. Tanya Stevens and ZJ Rush weigh in. Ioctane and Vibes Cartel names call up in Klansman trial. Popcorn reacts to Klansman witness. Stay tuned for the stories in detail. And remember to follow me on Instagram at Mota_Masi.
Man a hunt and seek and find. Paper money we a look not coins. That means said dollars and left the dime. One day I have to shine. Cause we always in the street. You have a skill to survive and this a hot concrete. White squalor bite and shoes on dip on me feet. One day it would be mine.
Massive. We can tell that this song is a quality song. It has a positive message. It's easy on the ears, and the artists are showing off their maturity and the passion they have for their craft. This one is called Hunter by Wesley Diamond featuring Agent Sasko and Keep Rich. Persons can relate to this song regardless of their age or address. We have to hunt and seek and find because one day we have to shine. Lyrics are well put together, and as such they leave an impact. Hunter can be played in any setting, and that's a plus. To listen to Hunter, please click the link in the description box below and check them out on Instagram at WesleyDiamond_Anointed, Agent Sasko, and The Real Keep Rich. Make them know say I'm Motamasi seno no. Our Prime Minister is currently in Glasgow, Scotland at the 26th UN Climate Change Conference of the Parties, COP26. So a picture surfaced with Bro God and other dignitaries, and guess what? Look panny for yourself and tell me what's missing. Oina ava no mask. Remember noina massive, the leaders of the world, they're telling us that even if we are fully vaccinated, we still have to wear a mask, we still have to social distance along with other protocols. So of course, some people were perturbed when they saw Bro God maskless. Tanya Stevens was the first person to highlight this. She posted a picture on her Instagram, then she captioned it, "If I know my rule is Chris, so I won't adhere to it," was a person. Then she tagged Andrew and Christopher, "At least pretend you think COVID is dangerous, FFS. In the comment section, we had Spraga Benz. He said, "Dip for diplomatic, hip for hypocratic, dry for dryland tourist, top for toponaris. See the hypocrites de Magalangde at Andrew Holness JM." Tanya Stevens responded with some flame emoji. Y Rush said, "Wear your mask, social distance, COVID still a keep." Tanya responded with some laughing emojis. Y Rush posted the same picture and said, "Good thing there aren't any corner shops around. No ghetto people around buying half a bread, so we don't need mask or social distancing. Like we've been telling everyone, regardless of jab. And a so it go, according to the CDC. Oh nah, I'm crazy. Life is now a badly written comedy. Hashtag Rufus, hashtag Fido, hashtag good boy." And to add insult to injury, massive, fully vaccinated LA mayor has tested positive for COVID-19 at the COP26 in Glasgow and is now isolating in his hotel room. So massive on the north of the Klansman gang trial is currently going on, right? No founder probably see the vloggers them run out with the story already as it relates to Ioctane and Vibes Cartel. But I'm just gonna go ahead and, you know, update my viewers. I'm gonna go ahead and read from Nationwide. The prosecution's second witness in the Klansman gang trial told the court that the alleged gangsters would often accompany popular dancehall artist Ioctane to recording studios. According to the witness, the reputed gangsters, including Brian, would leave from their headquarters in Jones Avenue with the dancehall star to visit a studio in Dunrobin, St. Andrew. He says the musician's daughter would also be in the studio as he recorded his music. So after that that article came out massive, Ayatin reposted it on his Instagram page, and he captioned that, "After reading this and see what they said about me, where and how am I a criminal? People, me never know say voicing music for an established recording company is a crime. My boss from me 16, 17, over 15 or more years now, and my voice for so many ghetto labels. Boss enough ghetto youths who are produce music from the ghetto and never involve or mention in any criminal activities. So I know. Just let me clarify something that I see on the net. First thing, no one escort me to studio. Do your research. People in the music can tell you I have my own recording studio. So when anybody wants to do any form of recording, then meet me at the studio. Next thing, why would I do in crime and have my little daughter at a crime scene? So if having my daughter who loves music at my studio when I'm recording so she can learn more, plus voicing for an unknown recording company, where is the crime? Okay then, that means that the majority of Jamaican artists are criminal then. I am one of the biggest Jamaican superstars for years now. So let me tell you this. I have come across over my 15 years enough youth who inner badness because of their background, but come to me and say, DJ, help take me out of badness. Note, I don't know nothing about them badness, but them ask for help just to record a song on a rhythm so they can get into producing. I'm not gonna tell no lies. Me record for them over and over because I want to show them say life no stop a badness. Jones Avenue Records is a big recording label and multiple artists have done recording for them. So now, Ayatin is a criminal for do the same thing? One, when it's election time and I sing dubs of politicians on both sides, does that mean me into politics? When politicians keep the rally parties, I'ma go sing free. That don't mean me vote. Me never vote yet. When police are keep them party at the station, I'ma go sing free. That don't mean me I carry info to them. When bad man keep them ghetto shows, enough artists including myself go. That don't mean me in a badness. So, I don't know emoji. A main prosecution witness has alleged that incarcerated dancehall entertainer Vybz Kartel had promoted the Andre Black Man Brian led faction of the Klansman gang to carry out 3 hits, including on a fellow entertainer. The witness says Kartel's order resulted in 2 people being murdered in Waterford in Portmore. According to the witness, an attempt was made on the life of the entertainer but failed. The witness delivered the bombshell revelation during his testimony in the Wandon Klansman anti-gang trial in the Home Circuit Court in downtown Kingston. When asked who ordered the hits, the witness told the court, "This instruction was given to me by Vybz Kartel by phone." The witness made a disclosure while he gave evidence about accused gangster Jazeel Blake. Blake is otherwise known as Squeeze Eye. According to the witness, Blake was the driver when the double murder took place and the attempt on the life of the artist. The witness also testified that Blackman Brian had sent him to monitor one of Kartel's video shoots. According to the witness, the video was recorded on McKinley Crescent in St. Andrew. The witness says the video, which the Wandon faction of the Klansman gang was asked to supervise, was for Kartel's hit song Bokopina. After this story was published massive, several persons were drawing back on Serpy's video where he was talking about Vybz Kartel wanting to off Popcorn. Me no know if you remember that. And because them start call up back Popcorn name, Popcorn never have no other option but to respond or react to this allegation. Popcorn tweeted, "Una stop tag me man with no bag of fuckery. One bag of yapping." Well, massive. Una believe say a Popcorn the witness did a talk about. Do you think this new testimony will affect Vybz Kartel's appeal? Let me know. Any lawyers that watch this channel, you know, can give us some insight. That would be nice. So that's it for today, massive Montana. Big up on a nice clean self. Enough love, enough respect. Blessings upon blessings upon blessings. Positive vibrations going out to the massive. I'm out of Massey. Magan.
Mount a Massey. Covering the latest in Jamaican music and culture. Like, share, comment, and subscribe now.